class 3 EVS. Okay, we'll start today chapter 7, that is living and non-living thing. The world around us is full of things like plants, animals, trees, mountains, birds, books, cars, buildings and buses. We divide these things into two main groups. One is living thing and other is non-living thing. Living things and their characteristic. All living things which have life are called all things. Okay, all the things which have life are called living things. Human beings, plants and animals are included in this group. Let us underline the characteristic. Let us understand the characteristic of living things. Okay, now living things move. Okay, living things move. Now see, the movement in living things is one of the characteristic that shows that they are alive. Human beings can run, walk, etc. Animals move from one place to another in search of food and shelter. Plants do not move from one place to another. They show their movement in a different way. For example, a sunflower turns the face is of the to the sun. Okay, a sunflower turns to face the sun. Next, living things need food and water. All living things need food to stay alive and grow. Food gives energy to living things to perform all the function. Animals get their food from plants and other animals. Green plants make their own food with the help of sunlight, air and water. Water is also very important for all living things. Okay, now what we can see, one characteristic of living thing is living things move. Okay, all the living things will move. Okay, now human beings can run, walk and move. Okay, animals move. Plants, they do not move but they grow. Okay, they do not move from one place but they show their growth. Okay, they only grow. The movement of living things is one of the characteristic. Okay, now next is living things need food and water. All the living things need food and water. Now see, plants also need food and water. Animals need, okay, food gives energy. Okay, all living things need food to stay alive and food gives energy also. Animals get their food from plants and other animals. Green plants make their food with the help of what? Sunlight, air and water. Water is also very important for living things. Without water, they cannot live. These are two characteristics. Now, next characteristic is living things grow. Okay? All living things, whether plants or animals, they will grow. Okay? The clothes you used to wear when you were a baby are too small for you now because you have grown up. Isn't it? When you are a baby, the clothes can you wear now? No, because you have grown up. A baby grows into an adult. A seed grows into a big plant and a baby animal grow into a big animal. For example, puppies grow into dogs. Okay, these are the example. Baby grow into adult, puppy grow into dog, cat grow into kitten. Okay, all these things. Kitten grow into cat. These are the growth. Okay, a seed will grow into plants. These are the growth. This shows that the living things grow. Living things feel. Living things, they have feelings. Okay, human beings and animals feel with the help of their sense organ. They can sense changes around them. They can feel the change that is around them. Now, plants can also feel change around them, but they do not have sense organs. For example, leaves of touch me not plant and mimosa plant close when they touch. When they are touched, when you touch the plant, leaves of touch me not plant, they will close. This shows that living things have feelings. Okay. Living things breathe. Living things breathe as long as they are alive. Human beings breathe through their lungs. Different animals breathe through different organs such as lungs, gills, ears, holes, etc. Plants breathe through tiny pores present on their leaves called stomata. Okay, now living things breathe. Now see, living things breathe as long as they are alive. Human beings breathe through their lungs. Different animals breathe through different organs such as lungs, fish, gills. Okay, plants breathe through tiny pores called stomata. Living things reproduce. All living things reproduce means they give birth to a baby. Animals give birth to young ones or lay eggs. Most plants reproduce from seeds. Plants grow from seeds. Okay, that means living things reproduce. Now, non-living things and their characteristic. Non-living things do not have life. They are either natural or man-made. Okay, rocks, mountain, rivers, streams, soils and minerals are all natural, are natural non-living thing. Now human beings make object like chair, car, pen, clothes, okay, and houses. These are called man-made non-living things, okay. Now these non-living things are important because they make our life easy and comfortable. Now some of the characteristic of non-living things. Now, what are the characteristic of non-living things? Non-living things do not move on their own. For example, table cannot move, you have to move. Non-living things do not need food and water. For example, a chair. Non-living things do not breathe. Okay, suppose a book do not breathe. Non-living things do not reproduce. Non-living things do not give to birth. Car cannot produce a baby. Okay? Car. Okay. So non-living things, what are the characteristics of non-living things? Non-living things do not move. Non-living things do not need food and water. Non-living things do not breathe. Non-living things do not reproduce. Okay. Non-living things do not reproduce. These are the characteristics of non-living things. And living thing characteristic: living things grow, living things move, living things reproduce, living things breathe, feel. These are the characteristics of living things. And these are non-living things. Now, non-living things do not grow. For example, a small table will not grow into a big table. Non-living things do not feel. For example, a doll will never cry if you throw or you hit, isn't it? Yeah? These are the things. Okay? So, we have finished the chapter. I will give you the question answers and I will give you some homeworks, okay? For today, this much. Thank you.